What's up, good people? Welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is Isaac Insights. Thank you so much for your continuous support. And good people, I really appreciate for your continuous support. We are currently at 18,000 subscribers, and I really don't take that for granted. Nasema, God bless you. God bless you abundantly. Yes. So, good people, I'm just here at home. Today, I will say that today I had an off. I have not gone to work. But tomorrow, I will be somewhere in Busia. Yes, just to ensure that everything is being done the way it's supposed to be. So, maybe just to give you a brief, last time I made a video and hapa ilikuwa inafiekwa. Sasa hiyo mmaliza kufieka ingawaje. Hawaje maliza kufagia, but you can see. Nyasi ilikuwa mingi, let me show you around. Nyasi ilikuwa mingi, let me show you ile nyasi imetoka hapa. This is Usago. Look at this. Hii ni mingi, ni venye hatuna mang'ombe ze. Hata ng'ombe zenye ziko hazikulangi. Sijui if you know that. Hata wewe ukiwa uko na kitu, uonangi ikiwa na maana. But that is it. So good people, today I want to talk to someone. I have been receiving phone calls from different people. And I think that this is the right time to talk to you. A lot of people have questions, and these questions are valid. That, yes, Isaac, I have bought land. What next? So today I'm talking to those who have bought their land, either 50 by 100, others buy 60 by 40, others buy 100 by 100, others buy one hectare. Well, today I want to talk to you. So what do you need when you buy land? And by the way, most people are never told this, but if you are buying land, it's always advisable. These are some of the things that you need to prioritize. Number one, you need to ensure that you know where beacons are, beacons of that land. Ensure that a surveyor indicates the beacons before you start anything to do with construction. Because if you don't do that, you may build your house and later you will be told, oh, beacon is supposed to be here. So it means you demolish a part of that house. And I feel that will be extra work or extra cost in your life, not just on that house. After you have find a surveyor to identify beacons for you, for your piece of land that you have bought, the next thing that is always essential is this outside toilet. Outside toilet is key. In Kenya, it is just that we have a system that, you all know that in Kenyan system isn't working. Most systems in Kenya are not working. And that is why we go to do approvals for our plans. You are sent to public health and they don't mind even coming on ground and checking what is the health status of your of that construction site. And when you go to public health, if they were to come on site, some of the things that they need to check is uko na mahali pa kutupa takataka, uko na choo, do you have that outside the toilet? Because it's always essential. Those workers working for you there, they will be using it. Remember, you are just building a house and you have people on site. These people, they need to have a place where they will use for you for their services. Let me call it that way. So you need to ensure that you have a toilet on your site. Another thing, and this by the way, toilet and this, the following thing, are the two things that always make someone feel like maybe, oh, you are kind of strict. I always tell people, it's better you have a site house. A site house is always essential. Even if if people will not be living in that site house, but it's the workers, it is advisable that you have the site house. The reason to have your site house is it will help you to keep your material safe during construction. Remember, construction is not done in one day. Number two, if you live in a city, you live in a town, you at least need someone to take care of your piece of land. They can live in that site house as they take care. And so that you also don't have that pressure that, oh, nimeleta simiti mifuko hamsini, lazima nilete mchanga, lazima nilete nini, ziende watu wasiibe. So you need site house. It's key. So ensure that you have the toilet, the site house. Yes, after that, another thing, it's always advisable you do temporary fencing. Temporary fencing ni kama hii yangu. Unajua mimi pesa ilisha nikafanya hii fence, mnaona hapo. Just a temporary one. Let me show you. It's a temporary one. Mimi naambianga huku Western kuzuri. If I give you the quotation of this fence, mutalia, mutacheka tu uchoke, because hii miti nilinua muti moja. Acha niwaonyeshe these posts. Acha niwaonyeshe, let me show you. Here they. This one. So I wanted 102 of this. And I got someone akanipea mti na 5,000. Mtu wa kukata hiyo mti. I wanted this, by the way, the length is 8 feet. See fupi, 8 feet. So what happened is, this is just a temporary fence. I will do a strong one when I get money. But I understand it's also good because it's serving the purpose. So, what I did, I got one, someone in the village. I gave him 5,000. He gave me a tree. I got a tree. Unaona hiyo mti hii. Na si ati mchwa inakula, by the way. Si ati nembaye, iko tu sawa. Nivenye zaza, I'm calling temporary because I know even if someone sees this, will laugh at me at all. Zaza hii negano umefanya, but we did it because ilienda mpaka huko. Mahali mnaona ile cho huko nyuma ndio ilipitia. Ni kubwa. Venye tu hizi miti zimeenda around this homestead. So, 5,000, and then I got someone to... The power saw took my 2,500, so it costed me 7,500 to get all these posts. So you also need a temporary fence just like this one, and a temporary fence will give you sense of security also at your place. Why am I not saying that you go for permanent fence? The problem with going for permanent fence in construction is this, and no one will tell you that. If you go with permanent fence, that is, you are doing these walls, perimeter wall, or even the concrete poles, those are considered somehow permanent because it's not easy to get rid of them. The problem with going with fence is, during construction, we have sometimes you are bringing material on your site na unapata gari inashindwa kuingia. For me, ni yangu hata kama ni permanent, but niliacha njia, unaona ni kubwa. So if I was building, utapata nini imenitoshea tractors zikikuja zinaingia tu zikitoka. But we have people, you have bought a 50 by 100, you do perimeter wall. Time ya kusupply material, unapata tu gari kupinduka ni shida. Gari kupinduka ni shida. So it's advisable that you don't do a permanent fence during that time until you finish your construction. That is when you will do your permanent fence. Another thing that is essential. You see these trees that are planted here? You can see I have some trees here. These are always planted during landscaping. We have people who always rush to plant these trees. You plant such trees in your compound and you are still constructing.
I will tell you that that is a wrong move. You are not supposed to plant similar trees. Eh? The reason being, the ones on fence, they are okay, but these ones, this is a landscaping, this is a kutengeneza tubo makuwa mrembo. Please don't rush to plant them, because tractors will be coming at your place. Zinaingia, lori zinaingia. So kukanyaga, unaanza kuwa na limiting space. Eh? So it's better you hold on, ukisha simamisha nyumba yako, ushafanya plaster. That's when you can plant these trees, because hizo zingine zitataka magari kubwa kubwa kwa your site. So don't plant them. So I think those are some of the essential things that you need to consider when you are planning to build your home at a new place. Ukiwa unajenga kwa boma kama ile yetu pale, eh, na mimi. By the way, mimi site house ilikuwa hapa. Ni venye nilikaangusha, kalikuwa kanakaa vibaya. I think I will show you in one of the video when I was building this house. But if you are building this at your at home, then you have someone to store your materials, then it's okay. It's not a must that you have a site house. But good people, I say up to there, thank you so much. Another thing that I will talk about later, I wish I could talk it on it with details. Also, after buying your land and you are planning to build, you need someone to walk you through that journey. However, I understand most people always reach out, and I appreciate. Hey, lakini wengine wananifanya maneno. Mtu anakukimbiza, Isaac, next week. Next week nataka mkuje mnijenge. Nataka hii material. Wewe unajua basi, hapa kazi iko. Nitaenda tusaidiana na mwenzangu. Kumbe mtu anakusumbua tu akili na anaenda shughuli zake, which is not fair. I had a friend mwenye alikuwa ananiambia tu on Monday. So I have even told fundis, hey, on Monday we have a job, we are going to this place. Mpaka kesho jamaa hajawahi piga simu, na hiyo time amenisumbua, nimempea quotation. Ule fundi amefanya quotation, nimemlipa, because I knew huyu tukisha pata kazi, I will get back my nini. So he wasted my time, he wasted my little money, ile ya kulipa fundi. Fundi ndio akufanyia quotation, they always want 1,000 shillings. And then someone vanished in the thin air. That one we'll be talking about it later. But it's also advisable that you find someone to walk with you through construction. Again, construction is not easy. Even if it's building a one-bedroom house, you joke with it. You build it alone. At the end of the day, you may use a lot of money. I have a friend of mine who has built a three-bedroom house. And I know those friends of mine, because it's not one, we have more. Mtu anakuambia, Isaac, this house I have spent 3 million, I have spent 4 million. Na hajaanza finishing, so you can imagine. So if you don't find someone good to work with you through construction, sometimes you may go extra cost. Yenye unaweza regret baadaye. But up to there, good people, I just say thank you so much. Thank you for your support. If you have not subscribed, kindly subscribe. Eh? Kindly subscribe, tunataka tuendelee kugrow. We are working. Tomorrow, the house we started in Busia, we did the slabbing on Sunday. So tomorrow, we have given it some days to at least for curing to be done perfectly. So tomorrow, we will be setting up that house, and I will be on site. I will bring you a video of the slab. I will bring you the video after setting, and I know you will be blessed. Up to there, good people, I say thank you so much. Mungu awabariki. Mungu awabariki familia zenu. Na hasa wale wenye wanataka kujenga. Mungu awapiganie na mfaulu mjenge. Na mniite kwanza. Nikuje niwajenge. And that is my... Yani hiyo ndio kitu mimi napenda. By the way, most people I work with, you ask them, hata huwa anajiuliza, huyu jamaa anakuja site daily. Na
Hii pesa si ile transport anatumia tu peke yake, but I love seeing people doing construction. I love seeing my fellow youth growing. Up to there, thank you. Mungu awabariki.